2 weeks ago, I hosted my semi-annual junk journal / mixed media retreat. And let me tell you how much fun it was. We had a bunch of new gals and some of, you know, the regulars, I should say. And it was a great mix. It's probably one of the best that we've ever had. And I was so excited. And I can't wait till August to do it again. Anyhow, what I wanted to show you was the things that we did for our swap. Yep, we all made 20 things to share with everybody. And I'm not going to say names or anything here. I'm just going to go ahead and jump in and show you what we had. Now, I did realize as I sat down here that I did not put in this pile the things that I made for everybody. Every morning they came down and they came into something that Annette or I had made for, a little morning gift. I don't have them in here. I'm sorry. But anyhow, it is what it is. So here is a great big kind of ledger thing that this gal sewed down the sides, and inside of it, let's see if I can do this, is all kinds of ephemera, old and kind of new, but cool things that we can use, okay? This is pretty cool. We did have a teenager with us. Her grandmother is one of my besties, and she took an Altoid box, and look, kind of like a shadow box. She had over 20 different ones. Isn't that just the coolest? Yep, her and her granny had worked on those together. So that was a fun little surprise to get. Some mixed media. And then this gal made everybody like a little journal. And one of the other ladies had taken this while she was there and went on and decorated it up and went home with a completed journal. Now, isn't that fun? And let's see here. This gal gave us, well, she gave me a pokey tool, which I was very happy because I always can't seem to find mine. And then she took and made a paper bag journal. So again, fun with a little notepad and everything. I'm not going to tie it up. I have not been in these goodies since I got home 2 weeks ago. I've been tired. I mean, I've been really tired and I'm ready to go again. I have to go again. But anyhow, she also made a necklace for me, so that was fun. Everybody got some kind of different piece of jewelry. Now, this gal took and decorated up a glassine bag, and she put some lace pieces inside of it and, stitched around. Now, isn't that cool? Isn't that pretty? So I appreciate that. And then in this one, this gal, I think she said the digitals were from Graphics Fairy. She made a template. This is the pattern. And then she put lace and some trim and everything on them. So I thought that was nice. That was an original idea. She had never been to a junk journal / mixed media retreat. And yeah, so that was a fun thing for her. Oops, put that back in the bag here. Don't want to get it lost. I'm going to need that template one day. I've been trying to find a die that does that, and no success yet. And then this was from one of my besties. She is really good about sewing. You know those scarves that have all the embroidery on them, like the tabletop scarves or buffet scarves, whatever you want to call them? She'll take those and turn them into books, cloth books. She's had 2 commissions in the last few months. People will take the linens from their family, their grandmother or whatever, and ask her to put it all in a book. So isn't that nice? This gal, I don't know, this paper, I love this paper. It's like a craft paper, but it feels so good. It's like thicker than normal. And I don't know, I would say she didn't stamp that. I would say she bought that and then embellished on it. But anyhow, she made us an ephemera holder out of those ugly yellow envelopes. Now, isn't that nice? So that was a nice little thing. She put some goodies in there for us. Let me put it back the way I found it. I'm trying not to mess my stuff up here. And then this gal gave us some music paper and some other ephemera. And then inside of it was a bookmark, a beaded bookmark. Now, isn't that cool? I mean, look. Nice, huh? I like that. It's kind of like I can have a dangle on the book that I'm reading out of the library. And then this gal made us a spine dangle. And mine actually says craft retreat. So I really like this. I think it is so pretty and so original. Got some sewing stuff on it for me and my sewing things that I've been into lately. And this gal gave us all different kinds of ephemera, some library cards and the holders and some tassels and some different kinds of papers and envelopes. And here's some ribbon that I'm losing. It's falling out. Let's see here. What else do I have? Okay, this gal gave us, oh, her little flower just came off, gave us some little doily things, and then she did some French knots on a little card. And that was one of the things that we learned last year at the retreat, was the French knots on the envelope. So that is fun to see then that she took something she learned last year. Now, this gal took an envelope and decoupaged the whole entire thing. And let me tell you, it feels great. It's smooth. It's not ripply. I like it. And then she has an envelope full of all kinds of embellishments. Oh, I just saw that chocolate. I'm going to pull that out of there. I don't like leaving food and things out here in my studio. I'm trying to keep the critters away the best I can. That chocolate won't last long. I'm hungry. I haven't had anything to eat today. And then this gal gave us, is like a map made into a pocket, and I can see all kinds of goodies and stuff, and then she decorated it up really pretty. I have not opened this yet, but I'm going to as soon as I finish the videos. But yeah, so this was one of the goodies too that we got. And then one of the gals did this little flower pot. She does all kinds of different kinds of crafts and everything. And she says when she does these big ones, they are really stunning with the real flowers and everything in it. I got to put this paper clip back where it came from, and then I know right where it came from. So let me do that real quick. Try to keep everything together until I pull it all apart. This gal couldn't come, and she called me crying, and I knew it was going to be. I hated it. I really like her, and I had a lot of fun with her before. But she also took an Altoids box. And she went on and sent these to the retreat house so we all would have her goodie. And she said, please tell everybody it's a little escape. So when I opened it up, it sure is. What do they call that, like a diorama? Is that it? But she has taken resin. I want you to see. I'm not sure how good this is showing. But it is beautiful to me. I mean, I just love it so much. And my husband, I just gave them out randomly. And this one, look, my husband and I have always fished and have enjoyed it. And that's kind of what that looks like to me. So anyhow, so this was a fun little goodie. But that's it. That's the goodies that I was given. And listen, if you're ever interested in coming to my retreat, please let me know. Sometimes I might have an opening kind of at the last minute for the wait list. I do it in Northern Alabama, and I made a little thing that saves the date, and this will be for 2024 and beyond, hopefully, but it'll have the 2 weeks up there that I do it, and I do them during the week. That way, the folks that come from so far away can travel on the weekend. They don't have to take an extra day off from work the next week if they don't need to, and everything. I do it for an extended amount of time because folks do come from so far away, and I really want them to have time to rest and play before they have to hit the road again the next weekend. But anyhow, I made a little goodie that says save the date, and I'm going to post it at the end of this video. So if you should be interested, you can send me a note here on YouTube. That's fine. But I did put on my personal Facebook name on there that you can reach out to me via private message, I would prefer, and if you are interested. But remember, I try to do my videos on Tuesday evening at 6 p.m. Eastern time, and you can find me, like I said, on Facebook. I have a group, a page, a private Facebook. I'm also on Instagram, Twitter, and Pinterest, and I have a small Etsy shop. I guess the best seller that I have is my blueprints. And so anyhow, with that being said, I appreciate y'all. And remember, if you're interested in coming to a junk journal / mixed media retreat, let me know. And, you know, really all crafters are welcome. We do swaps and my retreats, you kind of do have homework, something that we all do and bring with us. And then we have activities while we're there, some artsy things that we do. Alrighty. So, but like I said, if you're interested, reach out to me and we'll have a chat. So I appreciate it and I will catch you going down the road. Bye.